Hello everybody, hope all of you are well, and today I will continue the chapter chemical kinetics. So today I will discuss law of mass action. According to this law, the reactant which the rate at which a substance reacts, is proportional to its active mass, and the rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to the product of the active masses of the reactants. Now, active mass of a substance means that the molar concentration. Suppose if we consider a reaction that AA plus BB plus CC is forming one product. Now in this reaction, what will be the rate of reaction? So here rate of reaction we know. According to the law of mass action, that will be the proportional to concentration of A to the power A into concentration of B to the power B into concentration of C to the power C. Now, if we want to write equal, so rate of reaction equal to, definitely there will some proportionality constant K into A to the power A, B to the power B, and C to the power C. Now, what is this K? K is called the rate constant. So, K is equal to rate constant of this reaction. Hope you can understand. And this is also the proportionality constant. Now, we will write the rate law expression. Rate equation for a reaction is an algebraic equation showing how the rate of the reaction depends on the molar concentration of one or more reactants. It is important to note that the rate equation can only be determined experimentally. So, if we consider the above reaction, that means this AA BB plus CC is equal to product. So, here rate of reaction will be proportional to, or directly we can write with rate constant, equal to K into A to the power P, B to the power Q, and C to the power R. So, what we are observing here? We are observing that these coefficients are not here. So, this PQR will come from experimental. So, this is an experimentally determined quantity. And definitely, this K is called rate constant, and PQR the concentration, terms of the power which are experimentally determined. That you have to understand. Now, stoichiometric coefficient and concentration term may or may not be same for a particular reaction. So, rate constant of a reaction can be defined as the rate of reaction when concentration of each of the reactant is unity at a given temperature. So, here what will be the rate constant? If all concentrations are equal, then it will be equal, rate of reaction will be equal to K. So, rate constant of a reaction can be defined as the rate of reaction when the concentration of each reactant is unity at a given temperature. Next, we will discuss the characteristics of that rate constant K. Rate constant depends on the temperature, but it is independent on the concentration. Higher the value of this K, greater will be the rate of the reaction. and its unit depends upon the order of the reaction. Next we'll discuss order of the reaction. Order of the reaction. Now, what do you mean by order of the reaction? The sum of the concentration term expressed in rate law, in rate law expression, is known as the order of the reaction. Suppose if a rate of a reaction is equal to some k into a, if we consider this reaction a plus b plus c, here we can write a plus bb is equal to cc equal to product. So here if we write the rate of reaction, okay, as it is exponential term, so it will be k to the power a to the power x and b to the power y and concentration of c to the power z, okay. So what will be the order of this reaction? So order will be, order of this reaction is equal to the summation of this concentration term power, okay, that will be x plus y plus z, that will be the order of this reaction. So order of a reactions, this may be zero also, okay, there are some reactions where order may be zero, it may be fraction or it may be whole number. It is an experimental value determined from rate equation. Okay, and units of rate constant for a reaction of different order. Okay, so what will be the unit of k? Unit of k will be equal to, that is the moles per liter or mole liter inverse to the power 1 minus n, okay, and time inverse into time inverse. So what is the n? N is the nothing but order. So when we consider a first order reaction, so for first order reaction n is equal to 1, so if we put n is equal to 1, then unit of k will be mole per liter inverse per second inverse. Mole per liter inverse per second inverse. And if we write n is equal to 2, then what will come? Then unit of k will be mole liter inverse to the power minus 1 second inverse. That means mole inverse liter second inverse. That will be the unit of a second order reaction. In this way, if we calculate the third order reaction, it will be mole to the power minus 2 liter square second inverse. But zero order reaction, when n is equal to 0, then definitely it will be the moles per liter per second inverse, okay, or moles per liter per second, or mole liter inverse second inverse, okay. So in this way we can easily calculate the unit of k. Next we want to discuss the order of a reaction calculation. How order of a reaction can be calculated? There are different types of method, okay, by which we can determine the order of a particular reaction, okay. First one is the by integration rate law equation, by integrated rate law equation. Second one, we can think about the graphical method. Third one is the initial rate law method, and fourth one, that is by half-life method. So one by one we'll discuss. First we'll discuss the integrated great equation. Okay, first we'll discuss whatever is there in your syllabus. That is only for zero and first order is there. That integration form required. You have to know. Okay. Now, a reaction is said to be zero order if its rate is independent of the concentration of the reactants. Let us consider a zero order reaction where A is forming product. So we are considering here it is a zero order reaction. So in this case, so rate will be equal to minus dA by dt, and this dA by dt is equal to what you have to write, that k constant, rate constant into a to the power 0, because this is zero order reaction, it will not depend on the concentration of the A. So from a to the power 0 means 1, so from here we can write this one is equal to k. So from here we can write that minus dA is equal to k into dt. Now what we have to do, we have to integrate both sides. So if we do integration on the both sides, then what we will get? We will get minus A, concentration A is equal to kT plus some integration constant, that is called I. Okay. Now, I is called the constant of integration or integration constant. Now, when T is equal to 0, then concentration of A at the initial concentration, that will be a 0. Now if we put this value here, so minus A 0 is equal to k into 0 plus I, therefore I is equal to minus A 0. Okay, now you will put this thing here, if we put the value of I in this equation 1, then what we will get? Minus A is equal to kT plus kT minus A0. Okay, hope you can understand. So from here we can write that kT is equal to A0 minus A. So from here we can write that K is equal to A0 minus A divided by T. Okay. So this is the integrated form, okay, of this zero order reaction. Next we will discuss the half-life period of a zero order reaction. What do you mean by half-life? Okay, half-life period of a zero order reaction, the time in which initial concentration of the reactants becomes half and is known as the half-life period, that is T half. Okay, so for zero order reaction, just now we got what? This is the equation divided by T. So when it is half-life, in case of half-life, T will be T half, and what will be the concentration of A? Concentration of A will be just half of the initial concentration, that means A0 by 2. Hope you can understand. Now if we put this value here, we will get K A0 minus A0 by 2 divided by T half. Okay. Now if we calculate the T half, so T half is equal to, we will get, that will be equal to A0 by 2. Okay. So from here we can easily, if we know the value of these two, we can easily calculate the T half of zero order reaction. Next we will discuss the integrated equation for first order reaction. So let us consider a reaction, that is A is forming product. Next, suppose initial concentration of this A is equal to A. So initial concentration. Then the product concentration will be what? Zero. Next we will discuss that concentration after time t. So after time t, what will be the concentration of A if there is formation of x amount of, if x amount is consumed of A, so product will be x, so it will be A minus x after t, the concentration of A, and here will be formation of x amount of product. Okay. Now, if we write the rate of equation, so rate of reaction, here we can write that will be equal to dx by dt is equal to k into A minus x. Okay, concentration to the power 1. Now, if we arrange this, that is dx by A minus x is equal to k into dt. Now, if we integrate this equation both side, what we will get? So, from here we will get that minus ln A minus x by integration, and we will get this one is kt plus some integration constant I. Now, where I is called integration constant. Okay. Now, when t is equal to 0, then x is equal to also 0. Okay. So, A minus x is equal to A. Now, if we put this value here, the equation will become minus ln A is equal to k into 0 plus I. So I is equal to minus ln A. Okay. Now if we put this value in the equation, this equation, suppose this is equation 1. So if we put this value, what we get? That is minus ln A minus x is equal to kt minus ln A. So from here we get that kt is equal to ln A minus ln A minus x. So finally we are getting that kt is equal to ln A by A minus x. Hope you can understand. Okay. Next, we will write that k is equal to 1 by t ln k by a minus x. So, this is the integrated form of the first order reaction. Okay. Now, we can change it in log base 10. Here, ln means base e is there. If we change this log base 10, then we have to multiply it by 2.303 by t log a by a minus x. So these forms you have to remember. Next we will discuss the half-life for a first order reaction. So what will be the half-life? So first we will write this equation, that is k is equal to 2.303 t ln a by a minus x. This is the first order integrated reaction, okay, for rate equation. So here if we write t is equal to t half, that is half-life, then what will be the value of A minus X? Definitely A minus X will be equal to A by 2. As A is the initial concentration, it will be A by 2. Okay. So if we put this value here, A is equal to 2.303 divided by T half ln A by A by 2. Okay. Then what we will get? We will get that is 2.303 divided by T half ln, sorry, here it will be log. Here as we are giving that 2.303, definitely we have to put log here, log log. Okay. So here it will be also log, log log. That means base 10. Here it will be log log. Then it will become a will cut, we will get 2. Okay. So finally we will get this one. So if you calculate the value of k, that log 2 value will be around 0.301. Okay. If you multiply it, you will get 0.693 divided by T half. So from here also we can write that T half is equal to 0.693 divided by K. So in this way we can also calculate the half life for a first order reaction. Now the integrated equation, if we want to write, these are not in your syllabus, that the integration for. Suppose if you want to write the integrated form, okay, for the second order reaction, that will be equal to K is equal to 1 by T into X A into A minus X. This is for second order reaction. Hope you can understand. Here A is the initial concentration and X is the concentration after time T, okay. That A minus X is the concentration after time T. And if we want to write the integrated rate equation for third order reaction, so for third order reaction it's quite complicated. That is K is equal to 1 by T X 2A minus X, okay, divided by 2A square into A minus X whole square. Okay. So this is the integrated rate equation for the third order reaction. Generally from your board questions are not coming from this part, okay. Only the zero order and first order, okay, integrated rate equations are there in your syllabus. Next we'll discuss the calculation of order from the graph, calculation of order by graphical method. Okay. Now we will plot the rate of reaction versus concentration. Plot rate of reaction versus concentration. So in this case, first we will plot the this one for the zero order reaction. So zero order means this is the concentration along this x axis and along this y axis there will be rate. So it will not depend upon the concentration. So definitely we will get a parallel line with the x axis. Okay. So this is for zero order reaction. Hope you can understand. But in case of first order reaction, so this will be the concentration and this will be the rate. Here for first order reaction, what will be the type of the graph? That will be a positive slope passing through the zero. We will get in this way. Okay. And in case of second order reaction is the concentration. Okay. In case of second order reaction, definitely rate will be dependent on the concentration square. Okay. So here we have to plot concentration square. Okay. So this is for second order reaction. Second order reaction also we will get a line, that is the positive slope we will get. This for second order reaction. For third order reaction, we have to plot rate versus concentration Q. So here also we will get a straight line like this, passing through the origin. This for third order reaction. Hope you can understand. Okay. We are going little bit of fast because very soon we have half yearly exam and we have to complete our syllabus within the time limit. Next, we'll discuss the plot of concentration versus time. Plot of concentration versus time. So in this case, you have to plot time along the x-axis, and you have to plot the concentration A along y-axis. Okay, we are putting the concentration in. Now first we'll discuss for zero order reaction. So zero order you will get a negative slope. Okay, so this is a zero order reaction. And next we'll discuss for first order. First order form, you know that here we have to plot log A, log concentration A in the y-axis, and time here. So this x-axis. So if we plot here also, in case of first order, we will get a negative slope. First order. Next, we will discuss for second order. So second order, here we have to plot 1 by concentration A. And here will be the time. So in this case, we will get a positive slope, and it will pass it through the origin. Okay. And next, this is for the second order. Next one is for third order. Third order, here we have to plot 1 by a square, concentration of a square. And here will be the time. In case of third order reaction, we will also get a positive slope passing through the origin like this. So from this slope, if we plot the time versus concentration, if we plot the rate versus concentration, if we get this type of curve, then we can easily understand what type of reaction order it is. Okay. When we will plot rate versus concentration, we are get a parallel line to the x-axis, then definitely it is a zero order reaction. If we plot rate versus concentration, we will get a straight line, okay, there will be positive slope, and passing through the origin, definitely it is a first order. And if we plot rate versus concentration square, if we get a positive slope passing through the origin, like y is equal to mx straight line, okay, definitely mx plus c straight line, y is equal to mx, not mx plus c, y is equal to mx, then we will get a second order, we can understand this is a second order reaction. And in case of third order reaction, we have to plot rate versus concentration cube. If we get a straight line passing through the origin, like y is equal to mx, okay, definitely it will be third order reaction. So in this way, we can easily understand or easily calculate the order of a particular reaction. Next, we will discuss that the from initial rate law method, we can also find out the order of a reaction. The initial rate law of the reaction is measured for a given chemical reaction having more than one reactant. The initial concentration of only one reactant is changed, and the rate is determined again from this, and the order with respect to the reactant is calculated. And the process is repeated with respect to the end, respect to the each reactant, okay, to get overall rate loss. And the sum of the individual order will give the order of the reaction. If we take one example, then we can easily understand how to calculate the order of a reaction, okay. Suppose if we consider the reaction that twice NO is reacting with oxygen forming NO2 gas. Okay. Now you have to balance it. If we put here twice, then it is balanced. Now here we are writing the concentration of NO concentration of oxygen, okay, and initial rate. And in this case, initial rate, the will be moles per liter per second inverse. Mole, liter inverse, second inverse. Now here, the first experiment, we are getting the concentration of NO, okay, that is 0.30, and when the concentration of oxygen is 0.30, here initial rate will be 0.02, mole plus liter inverse, second inverse, okay. The second case, if the initial concentration of NO is doubled, that is 0.60, then oxygen concentration will be 0.30, and what will be the rate? Rate will be the 0.8, or we can write here, we are writing here 0.02 and 0.08. moles per liter second inverse. So that is 0.08. Okay. And in another case, we are doubling this one. Okay. 0.30, which is the NO is 0.30, it is 0.60. Then initial rate will be 0.04. The same unit, the moles per liter second inverse. Now we have to calculate the order of the reaction. Okay. Or we have to write the rate law as well as rate constants. Okay, so from these two experiments, that is experiment 1 and experiment 2, we can write that 0.08 divided by 0.02, that will be the equal to 0.60 divided by 0.30 to the power p, that will be the order. Okay, so from here if we calculate, it will get 4, and from here 0.60 by 0.30, that will be 2 to the power p. This is nothing but 2 square, 2 to the power p. So from here we can easily calculate the value of p. So value of p will be equal to 2. That means we can tell that order of reaction with respect to NO is 2. So order of reaction with respect to NO is 2. Okay. Next we will calculate the order of reaction with respect to oxygen. Okay. So in this case we will take the experiment 1 and 3. So here 0.04 divided by 0.02 equal to what we will get, that is 0.60 divided by 0.30 to the power q. Hope you can understand. So here it will be 2. Okay. 0.04, oxygen is 0.60, okay, so this is also 2 to the power q, to the power 1. So from here we can write q is equal to 1. That means order with respect to oxygen is 1. Okay. So what will be the overall order of the reaction? Overall order will be that 2, that with respect to NO, okay, is 2, and with respect to oxygen is 1. So overall order will be 3. So what will be the rate law? So rate law, that will be equal to dx by dt is equal to rate constant NO to the power square and oxygen to the power 1. Okay. So from here we can easily understand this will be the rate law. Now from rate law we can easily calculate the rate constant value. That if we write that rate law that dx by dt some constant eno square and O2. Now in this case we have to put the value. So dx by dt in the first case if we put this thing then we can easily understand it is 0.02 is equal to k. Eno is what 0.30 square into oxygen is also 0.30. Now if you calculate the value of k, we will get the value of k that is 74.07 into 10 to the power minus 2. That unit is the same, moles here will be mole to the power minus 2 liter square second inverse. That will be the unit of this type of rate constant. Hope you can understand. And the last method for the determination of order we can discuss, that is the half-life method. There is one equation that you can use. Okay. So with the help of the reaction, some following reaction, okay, we can predict the order of the reaction by using the half-life period. And what is the equation? Equation A is equal to 1 plus log T2 by T1 divided by log A1 by A2. Now, what is T1? T1 is the half-life for A1 concentration. And T2 is the half-life for the A2 concentration. So, by this method, okay, we can easily calculate the order of a particular reaction. So, hope you can understand. So, today up to this, next day, we'll take one more class to complete this chemical kinetics, okay. And we have to discuss some numericals also, okay. You will please go through your book, okay. Read your book. Many examples from this chemical kinetics already solved. If I get time, I'll discuss. So today up to this, thank you.